Hi, Caleb with Brownells here, joined again by Mike from Sons of Liberty Gunworks. And today, Mike, we're going to be talking about whether or not you can overtorque your muzzle device and some of the issues you'll see if you do end up overtorquing your muzzle device. So take us through the theory.
So you can absolutely overtorque a muzzle device. I think one of the greatest indicators of accuracy is that bore diameter consistency going all the way through. Whenever you start applying too much torque to that muzzle device, you're going to get some bore constriction there, especially at the muzzle, the last bit of input that you have on the bullet, right?
Sure.
And so we teach not to exceed 30 foot-pounds of torque.
30 foot-pounds.
Yeah, some manufacturers might have a little bit different advice on that, but for us, we teach not to exceed 30 foot-pounds.
Okay, yeah, fair enough. And as you can see here, we have a muzzle device that's just hand tight on this barrel. This is a 5.56 barrel, have 28 threads, and we have a punch here that is close to the bore diameter. And don't do this at home. Don't just like stick a punch in your barrel at home.
Don't do that. But for science, well.
It's for science. All right, we're gonna ruin a barrel so you don't have to. All right, so as you can see, it moves freely in there. And what we'll do is we'll go ahead and torque to 30 foot-pounds. All right. And this should still move freely in the bore, which it does. Now we're gonna overtorque it. This is where things get interesting.
And where you see this a lot of times is whenever folks get frustrated trying to find the right shim combo to time like a suppressor host or a muzzle brake, and they're using the shims, and it can be difficult sometimes to find the right shim combination, to get that thing to line up. So out of frustration, people just go gorilla and use muscle on it. To get that thing to time up. So let's see if this holds true.
All right, it's a little stiffer. I'm gonna go a little bit further with it. So basically all that rotation I was doing was the crush washer flattening.
Yeah.
So now we're just gonna pretend that we're frustrated with timing our muzzle device.
Yes.
And we just wanna be at the range. And I'm like overdoing it because I'm 165 pounds, right? most people are a little bit heavier than me. So.
Yes, remember on this particular example, the crush washer is absorbing some of that torque,
right?
So a lot of times on a suppressor host or a muzzle brake, you're mounting that directly to the barrel without a crush washer, so you wouldn't have that cushion there.
All right, so it was like going in freely, and now I can still get it in there, but I have to like twist and force it. So it's obviously more constricted.
So let's take a look at something here. Let's push this in.
All right.
And let's see if, not gonna fall out with gravity. You have clearly constricted that bore. Now imagine the effect that would have on a bullet, and that is the last bit of input you have on that bullet before it goes out into the world.
Oh yeah, all right. And then flip it. Yeah.
Right. So, that's clearly what constriction of bore looks like.
Yeah. So that's a real thing. That's a real issue. So don't overtorque your muzzle device if you want an accurate rifle. Which who doesn't want an accurate rifle?
Yeah, I wouldn't exceed 30 foot-pounds.
30 foot-pounds.
That's kind of where we like to be.
Yep, and most crush washers will start actually crushing just under that. Mm-hmm. So you get plenty of rotate. If you're timing a muzzle device like this one with a crush washer, you got plenty of room to work with. So
this is more for whenever you're doing like a suppressor mount with shims and you're trying to get that timing right. And I would tell you, it might get frustrating. Walk away from the bench, come back at it. But you do not want to just gorilla it into position.
Yeah, there you have it. So just take your time, do it right. Because the extra, whatever 30 minutes you may spend doing it is well worth not ruining stuff. So if you have any questions or comments and you're watching this on YouTube, feel free to post them down below. Especially if you have any experience with this, you've actually seen this out in the wild, let us know. We'd like to hear about it. Again, if you have any questions and you're watching this on the website or, you know, wherever else, feel free to give us a call on the tech line. We'll be happy to help you out. And you can reach out to Sons of Liberty directly. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.